Hi guys, this is Nikhil from RS Education. So today the GATE exam was completed, electrical engineering 4-room session. So now I will discuss some questions from electrical machines based on memory based questions, you know, that students have told us. So the first question I have taken from the transformer. Okay, in this transformer, you see, this is a very interesting question, I should say. There are three windings. Okay, in this particular question, he has given a multi-winding transformer, which is having a four set of windings, as you say, and three of the windings are energized. Three of the windings A, B, C are energized from a balanced three-phase star connected source. It is energized from a balanced three-phase star connected source, and the source parameters are like this. The voltage is 230 volts at an angle 0 degrees. And B is excited from 230 volts minus 120. C is excited from 230 volts plus 120 degrees. That means exactly balanced, perfectly balanced a set of voltages. And there is another winding called as X. This is the output winding. You need to find out what is the no load voltage, terminal voltage Vx at this winding. Okay. And another thing importantly, he says that there are 20 turns for A, B, C windings and 2 turns for X windings. Number of turns also given. And another important thing that he will mention in the question, he says that the winding, the sense of the winding should be considered. What do you mean by the sense of winding, sir? First, you look at the A winding. You see how the winding is. The winding started from the back side of the core and came front. Now look at B. The winding started from the front of the core and went back. Now you see C also, winding started from the front and went back. You see X again, winding from the front and back. So you have to consider the effect of the sense of winding. So basically there is a confusion. What does this basically this sense of winding indicate? See, generally this sense of winding indicates this concept of something called as dot convention. In transformers you have studied dot convention. See, what is dot convention in basically a mutually coupled circuit like a transformer? Dot convention is a technique that helps you to decide the polarity of voltages on the secondary side basically. Now, what is a transformer? Transformer is an example of a negative feedback device or phase shifting device. Transformer underlying principle is Lenz's law principle. So, what does Lenz's law indicate? Lenz's law always indicates that whatever EMFs or currents you are getting on the primary side, on the secondary side, they will be in such a direction that it will oppose the cause producing it. What will be the cause producing some voltage or current on the secondary side? The mutual flux existing in the core. Understood? So, you have to mark your polarities of voltage or current such a way that it will oppose, it shows an opposition to the existing mutual flux. This much we must know. So, if you look at this particular winding A, now we can solve this voltage X by superposition principle. What do we do is, first we will consider the existence of A and X, and then we will check what is the voltage. Next, only B and X, add that voltage. C and X, add the voltage. So, the resultant voltage would be the Vx, as simple as that. There is nothing to think extraordinary, okay? So, if you look at winding A, how is the sense of winding? It started from back and it came up. Understood? Now you look at here. It started from front and it went back. So, when the winding sense is opposite on the primary side and secondary side, that means flux produced on the secondary side is directly opposing the flux produced by the primary winding. That means these windings are properly wounded according to the Lenz law principle. So, if you are getting some EMF on the secondary side Vx due to A, let us say that is Vxa, that will be positive voltage. Now you look at B. If you look at the B winding sense, it is from the front to back. If you look at the output side also, it is also front to back. How can the polarities be the same? It cannot be the same. So, if you are getting some voltage Vxb due to winding B, it should be negative because that will satisfy the Lenz law. Because in the earlier case, in the A case, the Lenz law is already satisfied by the sense of windings. But here, the sense of windings is the same and that cannot be the case. So, you must satisfy the Lenz law by including it in the polarity. Understood? Similarly, if you look at C and X, here also the same case. So, the voltage, it would be Xc, minus Vxc.
So ultimately the required Vx would be Vxa minus Vxb minus Vxc. Understood? Now what is Vxa, what is Vxb, and what is Vxc? See, you are required to find what the secondary voltage is. So you know that from the transformer principle, N2 by N1 will be equal to V2 by V1. If you want to find out some secondary voltage V2, turns ratio N2 by N1 into primary voltage V1. Now when you talk about XA with respect to XA, with respect to A is the primary winding, X is the secondary winding. So what is the number of turns on the secondary to primary? If you take secondary is obviously X, so two number of turns divided by primary side, how many turns? 20 turns into what is the primary side voltage? 230 volts at an angle 0 degrees. So that is Vxa. Again, next Vxb, similarly what is Vxb? So you have to take minus Vxb, so that is also same. X turns is 2, B turns is 20 into what is B voltage? 230 minus 120 degrees angle. Similarly, minus 2 by 20 into 230 at an angle plus 120 degrees. Okay. So after you solve this entirely, what is that you are going to get? You will be getting an answer is equal to something like 460 by 10 at an angle 0 degrees. So your answer is going to be directly 46 volts, as simple as that. You need not think too heavily. So most of the people might have given the answer for this question as 0 volts. That cannot be the answer. The reason is, see, if you look at the winding sense on primary side, A, B and C, if the question was given like this, that is A and B and C are given in the same sense, that means A also starting from the top. Then what would be the case means, since these three are perfectly balanced, the flux produced by them also is a perfectly balanced flux, and it will cancel out each other, and the net flux in the core will remain zero, and you will get 0 volts as the output. Understood? So that can also be understood by the concept of vector diagrams. How will I do that? So you see, if this is A. Okay. Now where is B? It is minus 120 degrees. That means it is lagging minus 120 degrees. So this is B. And where is C? It is at here. Understood? This is at C. Now if you look at B and C, they are in the same way. They are wound in the same way. So the direction of B and C would have been the same way. But direction of A is opposite to the direction of B and C. Therefore the flux produced by the A also would be opposite as compared to B and C, isn't it? Now the vector A no more remains in this direction. The vector A also will shift in this direction. Now if you will try to find out the resultant of this vector, the resultant will result in a flux of 2 phi m. Understood? So in this way we need to solve this question. So this was one interesting question from the transformer. Thank you for watching.